पवन गुरु पानी पिता माता धरती महत, दीज आर द ब्यूटिफुल लाइन्स फ्रॉम द गुरुवाणी विच आल्सो एम्फेसाइज द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द एयर वाटर एंड अवर अर्थ एंड व्हाट वी आर डूइंग विद दिस, वेदर वी आर जस्टिफाइंग विद अवर एयर क्वालिटी ऑफ दैट क्वालिटी ऑफ वाटर एंड द what we are giving back to our earth. So today myself Dr. Jyotsna Kaushal, professor from Chitkara University Research and Innovation Network and heading the Center for Water Sciences, want to describe on why we want to conserve the water. Because for a thirsty man, a drop of water is more than a sack of gold. So if we see the percentage of water present in our planet for the human utility, that is less than 1%. Though it is the 3% is the fresh water, out of that the 29 is the underground water and frozen water is 70%. For human consumption only 1% is there. And if we see in our India, we are utilizing the available water 70% for the agriculture purpose, 22% for the industrial purpose, and 8% for the domestic purpose. And in our domestic purpose, when we are coming to our households, then everybody on an average consumes 140 liters per day for the different activities which we are performing from morning till night. But if we see the other activity besides this drinking water, the water gets polluted when the industry, they are draining the water partially treated, or the other anthropogenic activities done by the human like the agriculture waste, that is the pesticides used, they are drained into the water and that water get contaminated. And on the other hand, there is shortage of water because as the population is enhancing, the consumption of water enhanced, but the utilization that makes the land to be dried. So if one of the data if we see, then 54% of India which is facing extremely high water stress. So what is water stress? When the demand is more as compared to that of the supply. So there the water stress raises. And if you see in the scenario, we are having a 54% in, rather it will get enhanced in coming 2 or 3 years, more than 54% in 21 cities which are going to be dry. So do we need to conserve water? Yes. Otherwise, sustaining the life on this planet will be a very difficult. So how can we can do very simple tips which we can adopt in our household. Generally, when we are doing the toothbrush, we are opening the tap and just running it. Likewise, when there is some leakage in the public points, we are least water to control that. That there also, if we can bring to the notice of any MC or nearby official admin, then that can be controlled. Likewise, if you are using the bucket bath instead of the shower bath, it can save 80% of the water. We are using the machines for washing our clothes. So there also, if we are using the energy efficient technology, that also can save the water. For the flushing the toilet, especially the Western style, there the consumption of water is very high. So there also some parameters we can adopt where it can reduce the consumption of water, or there we can use the recycled water. Generally, the rain, when the rain is coming, then we are never thinking for conserving that water. So how can we make our houses suitable for the rain harvesting system? So now there are so many methodologies existing in the country where we can conserve the water through the rain. Also in the agriculture, where there is lot of consumption of water, can we revive our earlier methodology of the making the ponds or some jal kund? So generally, even in the Chirapunji, where the highest rainfall is there, there people are preferring now the jal kunds, which can store water, which can give the water to the nearby areas. Also, irrigation that can be done through the drip irrigation, which can be more effective. Rather, if we are just draining the water through the tube well, then there is a wastage of water, and it is giving the excess water, which is again destroying the crops also. So if we understand the hydrology cycle of our water system, as we are learning this from our childhood, that is, from the seashore, the water get evaporated, then there is the condensation process, cloud formation, and then there is a rain. Now, whether this rain, we are preserving this water or just draining it, and because then it is going back to the sea, through the river, then it is going to the sea. So we are getting the water for our consumption in our houses, either through the river water or through the groundwater. But in every town or cities, there are the MCs which are treating this water. So during this treatment, there is a screening process. If it is coming from the river water, then that water is to be settled down by using some coagulants, then flocculation process is done, and then the separation of the sediments from the water. Then this filtered water is treated with some disinfectant so that microorganisms get reduced. So what the water we are getting through the tap water in our houses, generally it is the treated water by any MC or municipal corporation. But before understanding this process, and there is lot of market of the purifiers which are present in the market, and its industry is booming day by day, like RO, UV, ultrafiltration, activated carbon, sedimentation filtration. Why we are giving the importance to these filtration unit? And one of the report is saying that less than 5% people, they are analyzing their water before putting the filtration unit. Rest, without any analysis of their water report, they are putting this either taking this picture from the advertisement or the marketing style of the this water purifier companies. So what these purifiers are doing? If we see the Indian standard for drinking water specification, then these are the parameters which are to be followed for the drinking purpose. So here the total dissolved solids, that is the TDS, generally the sales people, they are coming to our houses and showing the TDS value. And if you see the Indian standard, then it is the acceptable limit is up to 500 ppm. PPM means parts per million, and permissible limit when there is no other source, then it is the 2000. And other parameters are color, turbidity, total hardness, ammonia, free residue, chlorine, pH, which should be between 6.5 to 8.5. Then the other chlorides, fluoride should not be more than 1 milligrams per liter. Likewise, there are so many parameters which are to be made. But the filtration units are sold only on the basis of the TDS. and they are showing the TDS which is required is less than 100. So when we are using some RO, which is a reverse osmosis process, then their TDS is generally kept between 50 to 100, because that ppm range is giving you the sweet water. So this is the TDS meter, and this TDS meter you can purchase and you check the TDS of your own water. Now if we see our human body, which is made up of 70% water, and every organ is having certain percentage of water. If we see the kidney, it is having 83%, heart 79%, even the hardest portion, that is the bone, that also contains the 22% water. And that means water is so essential for our body. But whether we are checking the water which we are consuming, or whether we are testing the water which we are using, whether it is coming from the filtration or whether it is coming by the MC treated water, that is a big question. That's why earlier I told that less than 5% people are aware to test their water. So if the, this is the WHO report, that is if the TDS is less than 100 milligrams per liter or ppm, then so many diseases can occur in our body. It can increase the elimination of sodium, potassium, chloride, calcium, magnesium, ions. Those are the lighter elements, but they are the essential elements which are required by our body. And they get eliminated because water has tendency. We are giving the water which is having the less TDS, means there the dissolved solids are less. The TDS less than 100 milligrams per liter is also having the decreased serum potassium concentration. It enhances the diuresis by 20% on an average. So it gives the negative impact on the homeostasis mechanism of our body. It also been observed that in some cases it reduces the volume of the RBCs and increases the water intoxication. So we must have to see whether the water which we are consuming from either any filtration unit, or if we are using some bottled water, whether it is under the acceptable limit of the standards which are given by the BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. So generally we are thinking that the bottled water is a safe water. So if we see one of the research data done by the BARC, Baba Atomic Research Institute, for the Mumbai water, so they took the 18 samples of the bottled water from the various places in the Mumbai. And what they found, that the water and analyzed from this bottle has the bromide content, bromate content, chlorate and chloride. All these are responsible for the carcinogen. Then what we are thinking, that the water which is coming in the bottle, that is a safe. So we must have to think before taking the water from the bottle. Generally, which we are, especially when we are taking this from the plastic bottles. Also, there is the depiction in the bottled water, whether it is the packed drinking water or the mineral water. When it is the packed drinking water, there is coding of the IS13428, and when it is the only packed drinking water, it is IS14543. Just to remember that for the natural mineral water it is 13, for the drinking water it is the 14. So you will find that when it is the mineral water, Evian or these Himalayan or whatsoever the bottles which are present in the market, their TDS is more than 150 ppm, and it is going up to 450 or 480 ppm. While in the case of bad drinking water, it is less than 100 ppm. So again, we have to think before taking the water. But the cost of the mineral water is very high. If you see, the 1 liter of the bad drinking water, where coding is 14, then it cost only 20 rupees. But if you see the mineral packed water, then it comes out to be more than 50 or 60 rupees. So we must have to ensure what type of water we are drinking, because that is deciding the health of our body. As our body is made up of 70%, every organ needs the water. So what the quality of the water we are providing to our body, whether we are thinking that by putting up some filtration unit, RO or UV or UF, they are solving your solution, then we are wrong. We must first have to have the analysis report. So as we are diagnosing our health and our body, likewise we have to analyze our water which we are drinking, whether we are drinking the tap water or the bottled water. That must have the parameters which are acceptable by